Hi, I'm Ron Mueller. I'm the solid state chemistry director here at Regis. I have over 20 years experience in the solid state chemistry area. I have a PhD from the University of Nebraska Lincoln in organic chemistry. And last year, I was enlisted by Regis to start in-house capabilities for solid state services. And I'm happy to report to all of you that solid state chemistry is now fully integrated into process chemistry, analytical development, and quality control here at Regis. Regis is a small privately owned company that's been established in 1956. What I'd like to talk to you today about are solid state chemistry issues. And if you recall, most drug substances are small organic molecules. Most APIs, which are indeed organic molecules, have the propensity to crystallize in different solid state forms called polymorphs. In fact, you'll see that it's been demonstrated that over approximately 90% of the drug substances exhibit polymorphism. Polymorphs are the same API, but with different crystalline forms or different arrangements. Those polymorphs can contain solvents and or water in either stoichiometric or non-stoichiometric amounts. Understanding and gaining knowledge of those polymorphs can establish robust API and formulation processes, mitigate risk, minimize problems, and ultimately reduce development timelines. Different polymorphs have different physical chemical properties, such as spectroscopic stability, solubility, particle shape, mechanical properties, and so on. Since different polymorphs have different physical chemical properties, identifying a viable polymorph is critical early on in your drug development process. There are guidelines for the industry. Let's look at some of those now. The FDA has a guideline out for content and format for the IND applications of phase one studies for drugs. In it, it clearly states a brief description of the drug substance, including the physical, chemical, or biological characteristics, and some evidence to support its chemical structure should be submitted. It also states that a brief description of the methods used, along with the proposed acceptable limits. If we also look at the ICH Q6A specifications, test procedure and acceptance for new drug substances and new drug products, there are several decision trees. Decision tree 4.1 instructs us to conduct a polymorph screen with the following question to be answered. Can different polymorphs be formed? And if so, you need to characterize those by the appropriate techniques. We'll come back to Q6A later. Here at Regis, solid state chemistry offers several different screening and selection activities with the goal of gaining knowledge for the solid forms resulting from those screens. Identifying the most thermodynamically stable form is the objective for solid state chemistry for these activities. Knowledge about your drug substance and your drug products continues to increase during the advancement of your drug substance and drug product. Let's look at some more guidelines for the industry. The FDA has INDs for phase two and phase three studies, the CMC information. By the end of phase two, it's clear that knowledge about your solid state form should be provided to the FDA, including a propensity to exhibit polymorphism along with other physical chemical data. It also states for your manufacturing processes, your process controls, and your characterization that you need to understand your neutralization equivalents, solubility properties, dissociation constants, whether it's hygroscopic, some of its thermal properties, along with powder X-ray diffraction used as identification, microscopy, particle size information, surface area information, and other physical chemical properties. It also states that for your manufacturing batches, what are the ranges? What's the relative ratios for your reagents? The solvents used, materials used, along with the process controls, your critical steps and intermediates, and specifically the control of your crystalline form. It also goes on to talk about your drug product for phase two and phase three studies. You need to understand your particle size distribution and how it affects your drug product performance. And what was the polymorphic form used in the clinical trial materials? That should also be included. Why is this so important? Because you are going to start your pivotal studies. The final polymorphic form and your formulation need to be locked in. This is your commercial product. If we go back to Q6A, decision tree 4.1 clearly states that if there are different polymorphic forms, we need to characterize those. And most likely, those different polymorphs have different physical and chemical properties. Decision tree 4.2 asks if different polymorphs affect the drug product performance or safety, if they do indeed have different properties. And if so, you need to set criteria for your drug substances. Decision tree 4.3 asks if the drug product performance testing provide adequate control if the polymorph ratio changes, such as dissolution. And if so, again, you need to set specifications for your drug product. Here at Regis, we can help you answer those questions about your solid state issues. If the API does exhibit polymorphism, it's critical to understand if the undesired polymorph adversely affects your formulation in your product. It's also important to understand that if there's any potential for the desired polymorph to change during manufacturing and or stability or storage of it, meaning does the polymorph transform, does the particle size distribution change, any other physical properties that change, including your chemical changes. By the time of your NDA filing in ICH Q8 pharmaceutical development, it states that you need to understand and their solid state properties need to be identified and discussed. It also states that along with it should be any potential effects for your API and how they affect your drug product performance should also be used to justify your API, your specifications, or the lack of them. Here at Regis, solid state chemistry can help you identify the most viable polymorph for your drug product. Regis can help you through the drug development process by building knowledge about these solid forms, which can help you build robust API and formulation processes, mitigate risk, minimize time, and ultimately reduce your development timelines, because solid state chemistry is fully integrated into the other services here at Regis so that we have a seamless CDMO operation. I look forward to working with all of you. Thank you.